Good afternoon, everybody. Wrangler here. And today, in this episode, we will be discussing how to get frauditors out of your office.
Silly Mikey. I already told your audience how to do it. Let's get to it.
Legal. Anywho, the latter of those is more for entertainment purposes for the video, just because we need to laugh to, you know, balance out the seriousness. But yes, we're going to come up with ways to show you how to combat frauditors in your office shoving their bullshit camera up your face. Enjoy. All right, guys. Now, here is probably the quickest way to get rid of a...
This is where Lion Mikey will tell us to play music, play copyrighted music. Specifically, play Disney copyrighted music. He must like Disney. I don't know. Let it go. Let it go. Yeah.
People are actually not getting mad that I'm walking behind you. Hi, how are you doing? I am recording now. Actually, I'm going to go back out because they had music going. Copyright strikes.
Okay, now that is, it's not a guaranteed way because some will still put it up anyway and not stop. But one of the things that, remember, they're doing this for clickbait. They're doing this to start drama just so that they can make money off ad revenue. And then later, when they get in trouble, they'll want to put it up trying to get GoFundMes or... you know, e-bagging, whatever it may be. But yes, if you start playing copyrighted music, especially anything Disney, it will come.
Especially anything Disney, it will
completely screw their whole day up. But let's carry on.
Especially anything Disney. Here's some copyrighted music from The Little Mermaid. Something that Mikey has never done, kiss the girl.
Strings, winds, words. There you see her, sitting there across the way. She don't got a lot to say, but there's something.
Imagine you're working in a post office and I come in with my camera. One of the customers says, "Hey, that man's recording."
Yes, you want her. Look at her, you know you do. Possible she wants you to. There is one way to ask her. It don't take the word.
And you say, "Don't worry, I'm playing Disney music." Because I'm playing Disney music, he can't put that on YouTube. Okay, that's one. There's another one. That was a kiss to girl. Oh, here's something Mikey needs to do. Cue the music. Yeah. It was cold out. Oh, there's a piano playing. That piano's got a copyright tag on it.
Snow glows white on the mountain tonight.
Snow, mountain. I'm talking. The postal customers are talking. The government employees at the post office are talking. The video is picking up everything. Now, I'm playing this on an iPhone, and I'm holding the iPhone near my microphone. Don't let him in. Don't let him in the post office. Here comes. This is Mikey's part. Listen, Mikey. Nope, I'm not yet. Here we go. There you go, Mikey. Let it go. Let it go, you little bitch. Can't hold me back, you lying sack of shit. Let it go. Okay. All right. By the way. It's copyrighted music from Disney. Lion King. What was that? Hakuna Matata? Hakuna Matata.
Expedia.
No, not commercials. Hold on. Go away, commercial. I'm low rent, so I got commercials.
See your perfect home from every angle with the Redfin app.
Sometimes I pick up the commercials. Okay, there we go. Oh, okay.
Hakuna Matata.
That's a wonderful phrase. Hey, Mikey. Did you know this is copyrighted?
It means no worries. For the rest of your days,
you have 5,000 subscribers. Do you know 4,000 of us are just watching you for the entertainment and laughing at your ass? So are the postal employees. So's Vegas VIPs. We're all laughing at you. Stoned Vet is laughing at you. Master Sergeant Retired is laughing at you. I'm laughing at you. The whole fucking world's laughing at you. Yeah, you got 1,000 or 2,000 subscribers who actually subscribe to your cult. Welcome to the cult. Welcome to the Roughnecks. Mikey, a swing and a miss.
The government building.
Which brings me to my next point. Is you hear a lot of the word salad bullshit that comes from these idiots. So
I came right back to his audio to hear him talk about word salad bullshit. I don't suggest tuning into him, because when you tune into him, you give him views. Views gives him money. He is monetized. He is a fraud. He is a criminal. He is suspected of murder. He is with very strong evidence, by the way. And he is a member of the Stolen Valor community. He claimed he had 2 Purple Hearts deployed 3 times. He claimed that he had soldiers over him that he commanded. Talk about word salad. Okay. He gives a lot of advice, and some of it may be good, and he gives himself the disclaimer. He doesn't suggest doing what some of the folks are doing, chasing the auditors, threatening violence and all that. I'll give him credit. He says don't do the right. He doesn't suggest doing that, but he sure enjoys that happening. Would I see it? Ah, yes. Here it is. Not sure if it was this one or the other one where the fat slobs in the parking garage were chasing the auditor, threatening violence. Here you got a guy coming at an auditor, and an auditor is backing up. Okay, if you want a Mike's audience, a frauditor, I don't care what you call us. This guy's all Mel Karen-esque. Let's watch. Now, what Mikey sees and describes is a guy getting rid of the auditor. Don't know what page this is from, which auditor this is, but this Mel Karen is exactly what gives view counts. You see a guy wigging out and acting like a little baby. Okay, maybe a big baby. Now, is the auditor running from him, or is he just dragging out the scene by keep backing up? I don't know. But what I see is view count gold. Because people who tune into First Amendment audit videos love to see this kind of stuff. Love to see security guards say stupid stuff. Unfortunately, they love to see cops say stupid stuff. I'm fortunate to live in an area where the cops are very smart, but I've seen some audits out there where the cops ain't so bright. And it's one time I was up in Sherrill, New York, and that cop there in Sherrill, New York, who demanded my ID on a public street, that's one of my higher counts, Sherrill, New York. Can't remember what I named it, but go ahead and look it up. It's the more recent one, not the one with the chimpanzees and monkeys dancing around saying, I want to film an old man's ass. But the other one where the male cop and the female cop come up to me and almost immediately demand ID. They make total asses of themselves, like this guy is. He's making an ass out of himself. Yeah, what Mikey says, this is a way to get rid of the auditor. What the auditor is getting is something that the audience enjoys watching. So if you're worried about clicks and views and subs, this is the kind of stuff that people watch. That's exactly what the auditor wants. For you to pay attention to the auditor, you to pay attention to the camera, for you to react to the camera. I say the best way to defeat an auditor is ignore them. And I put that out when Mikey announced that he was going to do this video. Another thing I just saw was convenient editing. Mikey stopped showing this video just a little bit too late. The guy's coming after the auditor. The auditor's backing up, coming after him. The auditor's backing up. They go out the door. I say the auditor is dragging out the scene for that view gold. But Mikey forgets to cut the video just a few seconds shorter because you see the auditors are going right back in. I don't know. I don't know what the original video is, if he goes back in and gets the guy riled up some more or what. But that's not how you do it. This is how you do it. This is my main channel. I see I'm running some copyright tests, and I got a couple. I'll go over those in a few minutes. But I want to cover my smaller channel, which is also not monetized, at a whopping 80 subscribers and 55 videos. Let me see, Geezer, that's me. Cop Mikey in another lie. How to fuzz, advanced copy on how to deal with frauditors. Let's see what I said you about watched, that. I gave him the answer.
One of this knucklehead's live streams.
Welcome to the Roughnecks. What a geek, what an idiot. Okay. Here's the answer on how to get rid of an auditor, or how to waste his time. It takes a lot of time to do it. Are you ready?
Start the clock.
Ignore them. That's all the low attention span Wrangler. Boom. That's it. Ignore them. Now, there are... auditors, pain in the ass, they do heckle people. And then you can get them for harassment. I'm sorry, you shouldn't heckle people. I just saw something on Vegas VIP's channel where there's an auditor somewhere in his area who definitely crosses the line, goes into neighborhoods and pounds on doors and yells into the doors. That's a definite no-go. But that's not what most of us do. Yeah, sure, Mikey will find them and point them out and paint them in the same with the same brush he paints all of us. But there are definitely lines. Let's stop this one.
No, it's private. It's not publicly funded.
I'm sorry?
This is not publicly funded?
It is, but it has to all be approved through the city of Las Vegas. So you have to go over and talk with the city of Las Vegas and go through the communications directors.
To
get the approval. And then
to engage in my First Amendment right, I have...
Now, in that one, a rare moment, I have to give Mikey credit. A fire station is not public access. I'm sorry, it's just not. A post office is. A post office is not only a government entity... It is also public access. Poster 7 makes it very clear. Now, I disagree with a lot of auditors. I say, you can go in there and you can record. And if customers say you can't record, thumb your nose at them. If employees say you can't record, thumb your nose at them. However, I differ from a lot of auditors. If I am told to leave by the police, by the DHS Protection Force, or by the postal employees, then I should honor that and leave. A workaround is when they say you have to be there to conduct business, buy a stamp, buy a book of stamps, buy a package. You know, they sell stuff there, buy something, and then you have a right to be there.
But yeah, a fire station, no. You can stand on the sidewalk, and Mikey points that out. You can stand on the sidewalk and do your bit there. Okay. Hopefully, the music is loud enough that you can hear it. And hopefully it's loud enough that YouTube can hear it. But let's go back over to my primary channel where I'm running some tests. Okay, I did get a copy strike on Bonnie Raitt on this very song. I did not on some other Disney tests, and you'll see that from what you just did. I'm sorry, there was one Disney test where I did get a copyright strike. But it's a non-affected copyright strike. There were two. I had the option of muting, and I can do it again here. Select action, mute song, continue. Now, you can mute all sound when the song plays. Ah, this is a bad example. Mute song only. If they get enough information about the song, their AI can actually go in there and take out the music and leave the dialogue, the part where I'm talking, and leave and cut out the Bonnie part. Now, the reason I picked Bonnie is because I've heard a lot of controversy how Bonnie likes to... But Bonnie's very strict about sharing her copyrighted material. And this is a test of this very song, and yes, it got a copyright strike. Now, if I was monetized, this would be a problem, because I'm doing it for the money, right? Let's see, the content claim on your video doesn't affect your channel. Even though it's playing in the background, it doesn't affect my channel. This is not a copyright strike. So go ahead and play your Disney music when you see my camera. Go ahead and play your Bonnie music. It gives great sound, a background sound. Now again, I can select action. I can trim, I can replace, I can mute. Oh, okay, it doesn't give me an option to mute. Why? Because it's really not a big deal. And Bonnie Raitt is one of the biggest advocates of not taking someone else's music. Okay, Bonnie, I love you, but shut up. Okay. There are music out there that will fully block you. I recently had a video that I noticed back in May. I included it in my year in review with a lady at a McDonald's. Did not like my camera. I panned past her car and she freaked out at me and came at me, and I included it in my year review, but when I included it, I noticed one of these copyright strikes. Where is it? A little bit further back. Oh, we're in July. It's back way back in May, I believe. Let's go all the way back to June. Okay, got a little bit further to go. Accentuate the positive. Oh man, I forgot to put Beyond Hello. I'm like in July now. That was a good one. How did I miss that? Yeah, well, because I digress. Mikey, that's not your word. Shut up. There she is, Karen here. West Springfield Karen. You need to delete that. She told me to delete it. I didn't. She parked her van. I don't know where she was going, but she hesitated long enough to realize the police weren't going to do anything because there's nothing wrong with me standing on a sidewalk and recording. Now, I got rid of it because... where's the copyright strike? Give me copyright strike. There's one. Okay. This copyright strike is for Frank Sinatra. I did it my way. In fact, this is an example of when the police and the postal employee asked me to leave. I left. And I actually took a lot of flack for that. It's My Way by Frank Sinatra. It's not affected. It's still fully public. The problem with West Springfield Karen, you need to delete that, is when I went to do my annual review just a couple days ago,
this was a it was a restriction, a copyright restriction. And I can't find another example right now, but the kind of restriction it was, didn't allow that music to be played, therefore my entire video to be played in some areas. I'm not bragging. I kind of laugh at Mike when he told me to stop riding his bike, or I'm not going to get views off his back. Silly Mikey. Now, it was around this number. There's a few more now, because now it can be seen in England or Germany or wherever it was blocked. The song was Michael Jackson's She's Out of My Life. She's Out of My Life. And you see me make an example of this, and actually when I actually muted the song. Muting the song took away the copyright strike, but even with that, by the time it came, it's December, by the time I came across and realized that there's a copyright strike, it had over 20,000 views. Now, let's take a look at Mr. Fraud at Wrangler. And he's not doing bad. I'm not making fun of his 5,002 subscribers. He's a couple thousand behind me. I think he's got more views because he's got, 715 views of videos. He has all the time in the world because he doesn't have a job. He does nothing but edit and critiques videos all day long. Sometimes he calls it adult stuff. He means doing his father's lawn because he lives with daddy for free. But anyway, videos, the most popular video, and he doesn't have any copyright strikes, even though he uses snippets from movies and TV shows, which I do that too. I used to see a lot of West Wing stuff on mine. The most popular is 19,000 4 months ago. Let's see, was this December, November, October, September? So he's had since July for this thing to accumulate views, and it's 19,000 views. I'm not knocking that. My typical channel, my typical view count for a an actual for what I do is 4,000, 5,000, 4,000. My top rating, and I'm not bragging about this, it's now 182,000, 108,000. Not bragging, pointing out that even with copyright strikes, I still do okay. And if you don't believe that I'm not monetized, here's the earn. Got it. Okay. It's telling me how I can start earning money. I don't make money off of this. A lot of the other auditors don't. Just in the last 6-7 weeks, I had a conversation with Vegas VIPs where he had just gone monetized. He'd been doing this for quite some time for free. Mikey, and you're saying that we don't have jobs and we do this for the money. Bite me. I think I digressed again. That's not Mikey's word. By the way, if you choose to mute the show, the copyright strike will go. There's different kinds of copyright strikes. There's the no impacts. There's the... it's very hard to find music that will actually be blocked. You're more likely to find, we note that this music belongs to somebody else, but it's not going to stop me from getting views. It might stop me if I was monetized from making money off it. I'm not in it for the money. You know who's in it for the money? This guy. I was asked to put up this up here. Bullshit, you put it up there. He wants you to send money through his Cash App. Also, if you go to one of his live shows, well, first you have to subscribe. And if you do subscribe, you can gift people memberships, which you have to buy a membership. And he thrives on that. I don't know what a membership costs. I don't care. I'd never give this shithead money. But here's another example. Stop. Okay. James Conway, for $5, says, why hasn't the prosecutor called in the woman who was there when the joint was found? That would clear all this up in 5 minutes. I guess this is a big hubbub about joints, marijuana, drugs, which this guy is an addict. He may be in recovery, he may not, I'm not sure. But you can, over here, you can enter chat all you want. And unless you're what he calls a frauditor, like me, and explain that the government, that the post office is government, he will boot you or block your chat and make me call you out and say, you know, get out of here, stop riding my back, blah, blah, blah. By riding his back, he means I'm supposed to get more subscribers by getting attention on his channel. He's got 2,000 less subscribers than me. He is moving up, probably because we're giving him attention. People are talking about him. But the only way you're going to get this splash here is if you give money. I've seen $1.99. I've seen $5. I saw one the other night for $19.99. People will spend $19.99 just to get noticed so that they can have this big screen. Here's another example of how I struggle with the live software. Here's another example of getting popped up to... I was in one out there, live with David Finkel. Okay, see, I'm popular. Still muted here. There we go. Oh, that's a warning. That's not a chat. Can't find an example. This is the one of Muxter. By the way, this Ben character is Hua. You don't know what that is, do you, Mike? You don't know what Hua is. I can't seem to find an example. There it is. Matthew the King says, the other day this guy walked up to me and said a minute ago, you found my car, and then he said, why are you in my face? I don't remember the context of that comment, but Matthew the King made a comment which caught Vegas's attention. He didn't give Vegas money. He just said something that either Vegas liked or hated, or it just caught his attention, and he shared it with the community. Not for a single dime. Let's go back to Frauditor, says we're making money off of this because we don't have jobs. Any video. Let's go to any video. Oh, that's Vegas. I'm sorry. I apologize, Vegas. I confused you for Fraudit. Big, big mistake. Okay, Fraudit. By the way, this icon, he admitted that someone gifted it to him. He did not create it. Something about that, someone decided he didn't want to be friends anymore and wanted it back, but let's see who owns this. Image, search the web for this image. It's in several places. How Uncle Sam can encourage corporations to be more patriotic. The Sleeping Giant Waking Up, MG Show. Fraudit Wrangler does not own Uncle Sam's image. Sorry. I was going somewhere off this. Oh, yes. Let's take a video. Any video? Okay, I'm going to go. I'm going to close my eyes. I'm going to wiggle my mouse. And wherever I stop, the closest video. Okay, here's a dumbwaiter confused by the forum doctrine. Let's look at that video and scroll down just a little bit. Oh, look at this. You can buy stuff. Roughnecks Crew. Roughneck Crew Mug. Another Roughneck Crew Nug. Roughneck Classic. He's selling merch. And I have no problem with people selling merch. I have no problem of people being monetized. I actually don't have a problem with, if you want to get attention, you have to give them a donation. But he goes on and on and on about how we YouTube amateurs don't have jobs. Dude, the taxes I pay are more than your subsidies, your government handouts, your what do they call those food stamp cards? EB, I can't remember them. You're living in... All right, I'm going to stop. You're producing way too many videos from that very chair in that very room in your dad's basement to actually get out there and do any kind of work. Okay, I'm going to shut up. And I got to stop watching this asshole because every time I click and watch something, he gets something. I don't know. What does monetize mean? You get a nickel a view, a dollar, a penny? I don't know. But this guy, this is what he does for a living.